Imagine. You are around 20 years old, male, gay, working as analyst on the intelligence of the United States Army in Baghdad. So you were stuck on the most unadvanced ambient of Occident at one of dangerous places of Middle East. Imagine that one day you have in front of you plenty awful, rotten and stinky data about your bosses. A lot of data that the people must know. Hundreds of things that you know if comes to light will change the world radically. Truths that will end with hundreds of thousands of injustices, murders and other abuses of power. Imagine that one day, you ask worried to a friend what can you do with all these data and the implications that can have when suddenly, before you realize it, your ethics defeat your survival instinct and you sent the data anonymously to a non-private media. You think you have signed your death sentence, but you did what is right, the only good thing that you can do. You pray for it to be overwhelming and cathartic for the people, and to not be known that you did it, at least until they appreciate what you have done for them. Imagine that your friend betrays you, and then someone knocks your door and take you to a prison in Kuwait, just because you did what you knew was right. Imagine that happened years ago. Now you are 24 years old and you had been transferred from that prison on Middle East to a maximum security prison in Quantico, completely isolated of everything and everyone. Imagine being Bradley Manning. Manning was accused of being the source of 400,000 documents that WikiLeaks have been publishing. Files that we can find the collateral murder video, where people can saw US Army shooting unarmed civilians as if was a game. But Manning has not been awarded by his honor. Instead, he has been kept on the highest level of cruel and inhumane detention regime created by the United States in Quantico, Virginia, where he has been isolated for 23 hours a day, 7 days a week. In his small cell he had forbidden the exercise. He didn't even have pillow or sheets. Deprived of his glasses and any personal accessories, he lived in a 7-square-foot cell, naked, with the fake excuse of being a suicidal. With the only humane hour that he had, he was forbidden to watch the news or to have any other contact with the reality. Frightful methods like the ones we saw at Guantanamo Bay. Because of the scandal about the horrible behavior on him, Bradley was taken to Fort Leavenworth, in Kansas, on April of past year. On this new prison, he can use his glasses again. His cell is a little bit bigger and have electric light. Apparently, the torture had ended, but no one knew that he was taken to Fort Leavenworth for the rest of his life. Without real information in media, by censorship and because his case haven't had the Julian Assange popularity, Bradley Manning have been suffering years of tortures and he is being pushed to insanity. Punished with some of the horror thoughts precisely he was trying to aware us, such the tortures created by the American government on his paranoia of the Cold War. Methods combined with the ones of the Spanish Inquisition for that lie they call war on terrorism. Near the Day of Judgment, his lawyer David E. Coombs wanted to soldiers in Guantanamo, FBI agents, informants and even Hillary Clinton and Obama to testify. But Mr. President, biggest faith peace Nobel, don't want to share place with the biggest hero of his country. So if someone haven't realized how much twisted have been the events in this world, it's because that someone will never be able to dream to be so good, strong and brave like the soldier Bradley Manning is. Trapped in this moment, alone with the dishonor and humiliation that he don't deserve. He deserves the maximum honors. But the true superheroes fight is for the people and sadly they always fight in the shadows. Anonymous knows how annoying are liberty and truth for the powerful. So, for those responsible for his situation, for all of those who call traitor to the hero who woke us to say enough, We want you to know that Bradley is not alone. Now, more people than ever supports him. Today, he have a legion that never forgives and never forgets. A legion who united as one, divided by zero, demands you. Free, the hero, Bradley Manning. The heroic fight with us. The honest support us. The corrupt fear us. For we are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you.